Okay friends, this is my third video for the basics of MOP. In today's video, I will show you about the auxiliary. In my last two videos, I show about the alarms and engine. In this video, I will show you about the auxiliary. Auxiliary, there are three parts. One is scavenger, one is hydraulic system, second one is scavenger, and third one is cylinder lubrication. In the hydraulic system, I will tell you first. Hydraulic system, there is a HPS mode. In the HPS mode, you can run the left hand side, you can run auto mode and the manual mode. On the besides of that, there's a pump torque limiter. You can adjust the pump torque limiter just touch, and you can there's a two things are coming, activate and cancel. You can cancel or activate like this. Same way in auto mode, you can adjust auto and manual mode like this, and you can also set the set pressure of the hydraulic oil. Right now at the present is present pressure is 12.2225 bar. Same way there is a bypass valve, you can adjust and close. Every 3 months you have to check this valve is working properly or not. In the HPS system, there are two electrical double pump, one is master, one is slave. So you can change this one master or slave, one or two. When you can make number one master and number two slave, and you can make number two master and number one slave. This two electrical operation pump for starting of the engine. There are three coupled pump, 1, 2, 3. One is master, two is slave, one is lead, two are the follower. So three coupled pump, they will operate when the engine is running. For starting of the engine, this two electrical ribbon pump first. For starting, it will be useful. After engine started, this three pump will take over easily. This is all about hydraulic system, my friend. Now in auxiliary, I will go in scavenger. This hydraulic system is finished. Now I will go in scavenger. Scavenger, there are two things are coming. One is main, other is process adjustment. In main, you can see that there is a bypass mode. You can bypass the exhaust from the exhaust receiver. This one exhaust receiver, engine and scavenger receiver. So exhaust from the exhaust receiver, you can bypass through the turbocharger. There is a auto mode and manual mode. You can change accordingly, auto and manual mode. So you can adjust the manually and auto of this exhaust from the exhaust manifold to the turbocharger. When the engine load is going more than 85%, this valve automatically open and bypass the some amount of exhaust is bypassed through the turbocharger. You can manually adjust this one also. Same way, there is a bottom side, there are two motors are coming. There is an auxiliary blower motor. You can change into auto mode and manual mode. Same way also, there is an automatic and manual mode you can change. See, here also RPM is coming, RPM indicator for turbocharger. So each and everything coming on the MOP for the scavenger. The next one is more important, my friends. This is cylinder lubrication. In cylinder lubrication, you can see how much you can adjust the cylinder oil feed rate. You can adjust the feed minimum basic feed rate or basic feed rate. If the fuel oil is changed, you can see change the sulfur percentage also here. On the leftmost side, you can see the flow is coming. Then total how much cylinder lube oil is consumed. That counter is coming. Same way, there is a pre lube oil on the bottom side. You can pre lube. You can start when you starting the engine. There is a sulfur percentage, like you according to the base of the sulfur percentage, you can adjust. You will adjust each and everything. Okay friends, like you can see in the bottom side, currently sulfur percentage is 0.48. If the sulfur percentage is less, you can also adjust this one. Like bottom side, you can see current and new. Then any cylinder you can use, and you can change if you want to change the sulfur percentage, you can change and press apply. The sulfur percentage of the it will change easily. Depends upon the fuel oil report, bunker report. Accordingly, you can change the sulfur percentage. Same way, my friends, the feed rate factor you can adjust. Feed rate factor accordingly you can change. According to the basis of scrap down analysis and sweep test, you can adjust this cylinder oil feed rate. Presently the cylinder oil feed rate is 1.5. You can adjust from this arrow up and down and press apply. So for basic feed rate will be applicable for all the cylinders. Like my friend, like feed rate, if you want to individual cylinder, you can adjust the feed rate factor. Like you just test this one, you can adjust current and new, you can adjust and press apply. So individual cylinder also you can adjust the feed rate factor. And if after overhaul of the engine, you can also adjust the cylinder oil feed rate. Presently, number one unit is in running in condition. If you change any liner or piston ring, then you can adjust the running in cylinder oil feed. Like presently it's 1.2 and all other units off. So likewise, you can adjust like current value 1.2, you can adjust down and up, you can adjust like this. Then it is now presently 1.2, I adjust 0.1, then press apply for one unit. So this will change accordingly. Like it is changing, it is taking few seconds to change. Once it will change, it will showing 1.1. Now it is changed 1.1 for the particular unit, then close it, this one. So my friend, if you the last one is cylinder test sequence, you can change the cylinder lubricant test sequence, you can also change on and off here. You can likewise, you can adjust. So my friend, this is all about for the auxiliary hydraulic system, scavenger and the cylinder lubricator. So you can adjust accordingly the cylinder lubrication for that unit. Thanks friend, thank you, thanks for watching channel RSA2.